The next step is importing questions. So under question bank in the administration block, you have import. Please click on that. If you get an updated version of your Moodle, again, you may not have all these. It depends on the theme they are going to use. On the top, you find gear icon. Again, I need to change. Okay. We'll quickly demonstrate on it. Technomio, I think it's there. From there, you need to go to more and question bank. Okay. As always, click on expand all. And check that first radial button, that is icon format. We are going to use icon format for MCQs. This is the simplest format. And gift format for importing essay questions. I will do these two. Scroll down. And before importing, first pick up this category, MCQ. Please don't forget. Before importing, that's the reason I asked you to click on expand all. Otherwise, it will not be visible. You need to expand general area if it is not expanded. Under general area, you have import category. Just click on MCQ. Done? Okay, then. Then you know how to drag and drop. Your icon format. You open that? You just open that? Yeah. So, this is the format we need to follow. So, no need of 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers, just on a single line, and after A, B, C in caps, after this dot, one character space should be there, and answer should be in all caps, colon, then one character space and the correct option. Did you follow the same, all of you, for creating MCQs? Yeah, question on the single line. Yeah, it goes on. It goes on. Yeah. No, line space is not required. Please check with your icon format question layout. If any formatting errors are there, Moodle will not allow us. Yes. If you have a WordPad, then save as plain text. How did you create your questions then? You save as plain text. Then drag and drop this question here and click on import. Already done, huh? We are waiting for them, and they imported and clicked on continue, and then yeah, you close this and drag and drop this file. Yeah. Yes. Click on import. So if your format is correct, then you will get the number of questions here, importing 30 questions. If it is not correct. What is that? You don't have? Open your notepad and check. You copy this and we'll search for this. Copy this and open your notepad. Control F and F. What happened? Check. Why? Just type in only degrees, otherwise. Control F and decrease. Control and F. And only decrease. And now only with decrease will search with the only word sum. Find next. Yeah. See, good. See, here we don't have a full stop, that's the reason we could not import. But now you need to edit that again. Continue. And now I'll tell you how to edit that. So, why you have, you, no, you should have 30, na? Why only 6?
Rest of the things are never
count after that break. Wait. We'll do one thing. You select all and delete. Yeah, click here to select all and delete. Continue. Now again import that. Not create new question. Import. Expand all. So that categories will be visible. Yes. MCQ, it's already there. Okay. But it said 30 questions are importing. On the screen, you will get all these questions. Now you check all, got all your questions? Yeah, done. Then click on continue. Oh, you can preview each question. Here you have lens. You can click on that to preview. You can attempt this question and click on save. What happens? Click on fill in correct response. Yeah, see is the correct response. If you want to change anything, you close this. You close this screen. If you want to edit any question, always we have this gear icon. Okay. You just show us. Click on the gear icon. Yeah, this may be useful. How many of no one is from math, huh? Mathematics course or any formula? Do you use any formula or images, inserting images? Do you use that? Any one of you? No? Now, importing images option is not there. If you want to insert images, after importing with all these, go back. Go back to the question bank and you have this edit icon. So, using the HTML editor, you know how to, yeah, wherever you want to insert, hit enter and insert image. You know this image is there. Okay, you need to do. If you are going to train math faculty or chemistry or some, then you need to know this. They may ask you, if I want to insert a formula, direct from there. But Moodle also support this algebraic notation is enabled. Let me check. I think it's been enabled. Yeah. Directly they can type in using LaTeX form. I don't know anything about LaTeX, but it supports. Automatically it will convert all these into formula. Okay. This I can format it. It does not support any equations, just plain text only. By the way, you can also embed a video. In any question, if you want to embed a video, you can embed a video also. Okay. So, this HTML toolbar supports all these media. You can insert any media. Any queries on this? How to import MCQs? How to edit? How to preview? How do I insert image? How do I embed a video? Any questions on all these? How to create question bank categories? How to create subcategories? No? Once again, what? What do you want? Do you have any queries on creating question bank categories, subcategories, sub-subcategories?
Image, video.
Okay then. Do you have any video, any image? Now, come back to the question bank. They want from that. How to edit and insert a. No, here only. Click on question bank and questions. Yeah, click on questions, leave page. Click on questions. Yeah, we are in the question bank. Say, for example, you may need to insert an image in any one question. Edit icon is always there after importing. This icon format, it supports only text based. We cannot insert. So, wherever you want to insert, just hit enter. You know, on the HTML toolbar, in the next version we call it as auto toolbar. I think you are also using auto toolbar. Yeah, remember this as auto toolbar, not HTML. You can either insert an image. If you want to embed a video, you know how to embed that. Then save, that's it. Any queries? More than? Any number of questions you can import. Are, when I asked them 30, see, I think she's not ready. Now I think she created only 5. Tomorrow we are going to demonstrate this with 30 questions. Okay? That is the punishment. Okay then. So we are ready with MCQs. So we'll do that gift file. You open that essay gift. And we'll do this. This is also useful. It's very simple. With one line spacing, create essay questions like this. We'll import this into essay questions. It's not visible. Now we'll do one thing. You go to format and format. Yeah, font size. Increase the font size to 20 or something. Okay. Yeah. So you type in your essay question. If it is a short note also, and then curly bracket. Just open and close the curly bracket. That's it. Leave one line space. Like that, you can import any number of questions. There is no limit in importing questions. Not only 30, you can import 100 questions. Are you ready? You want to create your own? Okay. Stephen Hawking. I think when he passed away, I added this question. I felt sad. Okay, at least type 4 essay questions. 4, how many do we have? Yeah, 4 or 5. Not this, even course relevant. Okay. Yeah, just after this, full stop, just open and close the curly bracket. That's it. No space again between these two. You remove one and show us. You remove one curly bracket. Yeah. One character space and start open and just close. That's it. And file save as, check whether it's UTF-8 or not. File save as, yeah. Please remember, this is important. Otherwise, Moodle will, encoding format should be UTF-8. Otherwise, Moodle will not allow. Don't ask me why. It will not allow us to import. Yeah. Yeah. ANSI is American National Standard something. It's very old. ANSI. Done? When you are ready with 4 questions, 4 essay questions, then tell us. This we call it as, please remember, that's the reason we named it as, you also name it as gift format. For the next training, you can use same terms. Essay gift format. Yeah. Why? You remove this TXT extension here. Take. Remove that. Last one. TXT asterisk. What is that? Remove. Yeah. Now save. Done, na? Right. Short summary on metabolism. What is called? Oh. Everything is on metabolism. Okay. Done. Shall we import? Only 2 said done. Okay. You minimize this. I think we need to save. It's all. Yeah. We need to. Okay. I thought of dragging. We need to. Later, you please drag and drop on this Moodle enable. We'll do that. Moodle enable. This format is not there. Only I can format is a web. So I want to import this to my essay category. What's the next step? I'm on this editing a question page. What's the next step? I want to import these questions to essay questions. Tell me. So what's the next step? If I want to go to, where is that import? It's not visible. Yeah, go to the administration block under course administration. You have question mark, expand that and then click on import. No, we have 2 imports. Please don't get confused. This is yesterday we used for importing content. Just expand question mark. Please remember question mark import. Okay, leave the page and then import, then expand all. This is not icon format. Please save your file with SA gift format. This is gift. Gift supports some syntax we need to use for even it supports MCQ, true or false, matching, essay and all. If time permits, we'll do all this. Okay. And category, choose the category, scroll down to import category and choose now essay. Yeah. Are you in sync with us? Huh? Are any queries? What happened to your, you downloaded my na? Okay, okay then. Now you start doing this essay. We are doing essay. You don't have essay? No, please create essay. No, nothing. Go to category. You created true or false and you are importing that. Okay, now we will do this under this essay. Okay, add category. Now you go to import again. Now you pick up that. Expand all so that all the fields will be gift format. Please check the gift format, not it's not an icon format. Yeah, I say okay, then done. Yeah, you just drag and drop the file. I say gift. Where is that? We close that. It's there. I say gift. Yes, it's there. Okay. No need of gift format. Just open a notepad. Type. Yeah. Can you show us again that gift? Wait. Yeah. Open a notepad. After every question, for gift format, one line space is mandatory. In the icon format, it's not mandatory. Please remember that. And we need to save it as encoding file is UTF-8. Even for icon or essay, anything that is important. And try to remember this as gift for importing essays, we used gift format. Just we are following the format, similar way we did for icon format. Just to save as give a file name and encode, change the encode UTF-8. That's this is the gift format for importing this format is gift format. That's it. Yeah. For essay questions. And I think the full form of GIFT is General Import Format Technology. I think so. Please try to remember all this. General Import Format Technology. Next time your trainees may ask you, what is GIFT? I don't have full. General Import Format Technology. Okay, click on import. Now we are importing. So we have 4 questions. Click on continue. Now we are ready with 30 MCQs and 4 essay questions. You can preview by clicking on the lens icon. If you want to edit, use the gear icon. That's it. Now shall we create a quiz and pick up questions from the question bank? Now we are ready with only the questions in the question bank. These questions will not be visible to your students. Please remember, you can import n number of questions unless you add questions from the question banks to a quiz and open it for your students. They will not be able to see all these. So you can import as many questions as you want. What happened? Are you ready with MCQs as well as essay? Shall we proceed? Or do we need to be done? You all are from Moodle admin team or IT team? your faculty members expect you to be well versed with all these. They expect this kind of training after this workshop. So you are not, I think you should also practice all. See, they expect after me leaving, then they'll ask you only how to do
that.
Anyways, okay. Yeah, but you can't give go watch the video on Dana. They expect you sit with them and train. So. Done? Huh? Shall we create a quiz and randomly pick up questions? The advantage of having more questions in your question bank is you can randomly pick up questions from the category so that no two students will get the same number of questions, same questions. If you have 5 questions, you cannot randomly pick up questions. Say for example, if you want to administer a quiz with 30 questions, so 3 times you should have in that category, means 90 questions, then only no two students will get the same questions. We have tested that. Only 10% of questions random. That too, we can change the sequence. Sequence as well as options. How many of you have? None of the above, A and B and C are correct. Do you have such options? Do you use such? All of the above, none of the above, do you use? Then no problem. Use? Now you have all such questions? No, in that scenario, what you need to do? Yeah, can you show us MCQ? No, no, from this category you pull. No, no. All of the above, only B and C, only A and C. In that scenario, what you need to do is, first import all the questions. The reason it shuffles, if you import, just go to gear icon and click on expand all. Array. See, this is actual way of creating an MCQ. How minimum we need 5 minutes. Say for example, type question name, question text, scroll down, scroll down, scroll down. Yeah, default mark. So you need to set all these options. If you have that all of the above, none of the above, then you uncheck this, shuffle the choices. Come out, come out, come out of this. You need to uncheck this. So your options for that questions will not be shuffled. None of the above will not go as the first choice and something, okay? If you have such questions, please remember this point. Your trainees may ask this question, please remember. If you have such questions, otherwise, no issue. Huh? Okay then. And any such scenarios? Okay, we have addressed how to insert formula and how to insert images and all and this. That's it, I think. Okay.